Hello and welcome back. This is ESICON 2018, the 48th annual conference of Endocrinology Society of India. Well, ladies and gentlemen, in conversation with Dr. Anirban Sinha. He is the assistant professor at Department of Endocrinology, Medical College, Kolkata. Sir, how has your experience been so far with ESI and talking about ESICON 2018? Let's hear it out from you.
Yeah, this is a very nice meeting and going on, and we have been part of the ESICON since its beginning almost when I was student, and that time again as a faculty as well. Being in the part of ESICON, I love to come to ESICON, and this time ESICON in Bhubaneswar is a wonderful event, well organized, so much diversified, yet so much scientific contents in it. I love the event from its nature and their variety of expression, be it leagues. Their interesting leagues went on yesterday evening, and today evening there is a panchayat, and this is a newer way of looking at science and fun together, and that is really a wonderful concept. The organizers did it. Hats off to them, and welcome to everyone to ESICON, whoever not yet come.
Sure, sir. Also, I would like to add, since you mentioned the journey from student to a faculty member here, considering the scientific programs held those times and as of today, what kind of a difference or what kind of an evolution have you witnessed?
See, when we were students, at that time it was a smaller conference because number of the population in the endocrinologists per se in this country is small. So we had this maybe in the hundreds, thousand, maybe 500, 600 people coming in. And that time this organization was small, and we had still had a good scientific content, but the number of diversification is less because we had only one hall conference, and that content we tried our best, and our student is, we tried to see that science was always made best as per the recent trends in those days as well. But point is, now the contents have become more upcoming because of the intensification of the knowledge in the science in endocrinology is exponentially increasing. So more scientific data are coming in, and from compared to our time today, nowadays we have more Indian data in our country generated, so that we can share with amongst us, and faculties and the students working in the different part of the country, they are sharing their views, their studies in this forum, in podium, and they understand each other, they meet each other, they share their views, share their data, and we understand what are the different aspects of same disease in different parts of the country, maybe in the eastern zone, in the western zone, the pattern may be different of the same disease, so we understand each other and we interact each other to find out the solution as well. So it is a wonderful event, it is becoming more diversified with the time to come and from the previous days, but again the science has always been a cornerstone of this whole event, and it has still been wonderful and more persistent with these upcoming trends.
Sure, Dr. Sinha, also endocrinology is a vast subject as a whole. Talking about your area of interests and experience, also that the topic that was covered in today's session at the symposium, let's have our audience a keynote message from your topic as well as your area of interest from the same.
See, the endocrinology is really a vast topic and still a most evolving topic because most of the areas are still somewhere gray zones, so they are still behind, and even the data, the values, the cutoffs are still not consistent, because in our time when we as a student, it is a very upcoming event. Now it has been standardized mostly, but still there are more areas to explore. And today my talk was one of this upcoming and exploring areas of unknown zones. Rather, we know that diabetes is very rampant in India. We talk about diabetes day in and day out, but as a scientific part of it, we know that this is mostly because of insulin deficiency or insulin resistance. But there are other issues in the diabetes. The other component of the islets of Langerhans, where the insulin is generated, like the alpha cells which secretes the glucagon. Nowadays people are increasing research and studies, even in our country as well as abroad, the people are finding out that alpha cell also has a dysfunction other than beta cells, which is known as a cause of diabetes. My talk on that how the alpha cell dysfunction cause defects in the diabetes and how to recover that. And there are many recent molecules are coming up with that age-old molecules like metformin also has an effect on the alpha cells with the newer research talking about it. And this is a very important and valid point need to be addressed in the diabetes management, because otherwise it causes significant glycemic variability and also increase the cardiovascular risk that is important So, for example, the heart attack, the myocardial infarction increases with the glycemic variability, and that can be controlled by the glucagon control, the glucagon dysfunction correction. And there are studies, and many more molecules are coming as the glucagon receptor antagonist, and there is very recent trend of developing it, and there are studies in the both human model as well as the mice model, and they have shown that significant glycemic control with the glucagon receptor antagonist. But there are some pitfalls that increase the risk of hypoglycemia, but these are addressed nowadays, and maybe in the years to come we have a newer molecules on diabetes management, that is alpha cell dysfunction correction with the form of glucagon receptor antagonist. So this is a new area of interest, upcoming trend of known disease of unknown etiology, you can say it. So that is my interest, and my interest goes as a faculty of endocrinology in medical college. We teach students of postdoctoral trainees of endocrinology, and my interest goes mostly in around the maybe the Cushing's disease, thyroid dysfunction, adrenal disorders, and these things we used to see, and we research it. And even then young diabetes, we are now have a registry in our medical college. We maintain the data of young diabetes with our trainees, so that we have almost more than 200 patients of data of young diabetes, be it the type 1 or young type 2 diabetes, and we have analysis of the data and how they're responding with the insulin or different treatment modalities, how well is the control and how is the complication rates. We are studying and analyzing it, and it may be important factor to decide the treatment trends in diabetes in India, or at least the Eastern India far from I belong to. So that is one way of doing it.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sinha, for sharing a quick overview about the talk session that the audience and the delegates witnessed, and a very quick message that you also delivered for our live audience right here. Thank you so much for coming live with us here at ESI TV.
Thank you.